we suffer as a society generally from focusing on survival as the sole outcome that matters for infectious disease. But as we're seeing with long COVID, and we know with chronic Lyme disease, many, many patients survive, but they remain ill, and they remain debilitatingly ill.
We need organized research across all fields of post-infectious illness that involve patients with these conditions, that systematically and in a unified way look at the illnesses across a wide range of infectious triggers. And I think we need dynamic, strategic design of multi-arm trials where promising agents can be quickly added and those that are not showing efficacy can be removed without having to wait years for those trials to finish.
It is a critical area that is that is just expanding, and I've watched this expansion occur over my practice and then my subsequent years watching the literature that is evolving.
The traditional pace of research is glacially slow. Patients who are sick, they're not waiting. Patients actually try different things. And so they will proceed down this road of trying different treatments until they find something that works. And part of the problem that we're having is that process is going on, but we're not capturing the data.
We need solid outcome measures that are unified across trials based in existing post-infectious research, including biomedical markers wherever possible, and that include measures of quality of life.
This workshop is critical because it specifically does draw on not just neurologists and not just infection disease specialists, but involves multiple disciplines in which expertise from different areas are combined.
Just get all the people in the same room together talking so that people are recognizing that chronic illnesses following an infectious disease is a growing big problem that has to be addressed. You start getting a cross-fertilization of ideas. And that is the sort of collaborative approach and atmosphere that we need in order to be able to tackle these, you know, long-tail diseases.
Having a group get together without having the sense of, oh, I have to keep this close to my chest because I don't want to let on what I'm doing with my research, where people are truly open and discussing the possibilities. That's where you make advances in leaps and bounds, and this is the excitement that this kind of project has given me.
We need an urgency in finding treatments and trialing treatments that are closer to cures than Band-Aids.